Remember what it was like the last time the NDP was in government? Saskatchewan had the worst job creation record in Canada. Dead last. Since Brad Wall and the Saskatchewan Party were elected in 2007, Saskatchewan has had the second best job creation record in Canada, over 68,000 new jobs. That's 24 new jobs a day, every day, for 8 years. Today, Saskatchewan is strong and moving forward. Don't let the NDP take us back.
For those who are wondering about how you can have a tight budget and tough fiscal times and yet a comparatively strong economy, I just point them to 2009, when the world economy was arguably even in a worse spot than it is now, and yet our population grew, and the economy created jobs. So it's happened before where the government's budget was tight, and that's our issue, we'll deal with that, but the economy remains strong, as it has been for the last number of years, and it will be in the years ahead. We took over office in 2007, and here in the province of Saskatchewan, in the birthplace of Medicare, this province was presiding over the longest wait times for surgery in Canada. That's changed completely. Saskatchewan is now number one for the shortest waits in surgical wait times. We've added long-term care beds. We've replaced old facilities and added brand new beds, and we're going to continue to make the investments that we believe will improve healthcare for Saskatchewan people.
The NDP talk a lot about healthcare, but what was their record? The longest surgical wait times in Canada, not enough doctors, not enough nurses, and they closed 52 hospitals. Today, our wait times are the shortest in Canada. There are 650 more doctors and nearly 3,000 more nurses since the Saskatchewan Party was elected, and new hospitals and long-term care homes are being built. There's more to be done, but we've come so far. Don't let the NDP take us back.
I don't think there's a lot of nostalgia for the way things used to be when we said goodbye to a generation of young people who just left because there wasn't the opportunity here. And so I think this election will be about the expectation of the people of this province that we continue to move forward, that we lead economically to pay for better health care and better education, and we're going to work hard to try to meet that demand that Saskatchewan people have of their government. When I graduated, I remember so many of the people that I knew, my roommate, one of my best friends, were simply going to be checking out job opportunities in Alberta. They just felt there was no choice. There wasn't even an option. That always bothered me, and it should bother all of us. In this province, with all of our resources, with everything we've got going for us, we should at least give young people the option to stay. I don't want us ever to go back to the Saskatchewan where there was no choice for young people.
Remember what it was like the last time the NDP was in government? They raised taxes 21 times. 21 times. They closed 52 hospitals, 176 schools, and 1,200 long-term care beds for seniors. And what was the result? In the 16 years the NDP was in government, 56,000 more people moved out of Saskatchewan than moved in. We've come so far since then. Don't let the NDP take us back.
I think towards the end of the last government, people in Saskatchewan were really upset by almost a defeatist attitude. That people would not want to seek out opportunity here, that young people would just leave because that's what they've always done. And people in Saskatchewan rejected that, and so the people of the province have proved over the last eight years that that was simply not the case. That this province has great potential, that it can grow, it is growing, and will continue to grow.
I drive home to Swift Current most nights and spend a lot of time driving around Saskatchewan. That's how I know a lot of highways have been fixed, but it's also how I know lots haven't. Yes, we've doubled highways investment, fixed nearly 10,000 kilometers of highway, but more needs to be done. It's why we've announced the Highways 2020 initiative to fix even more roads. It's part of our plan to keep Saskatchewan strong. In 2008, our Saskatchewan Party government introduced the Graduate Retention Program. Since then, it's helped over 58,000 young people start their careers right here in Saskatchewan. But there's still more to do. That's why we will allow post-secondary grads to use up to $10,000 of their GRP credits to help buy their first home. More young people staying here in Saskatchewan. It's part of our plan to keep Saskatchewan strong.
The choice is pretty clear in this election. Action or talk, forward or backward, the future or the past. A party that believes that the best days for this province are still ahead of us, that we can hit every growth target that we set because of the amazing people in this province, and that's the choice. That's before Saskatchewan people. I know there's more work to do, but Saskatchewan is strong today. On April the 4th, let's keep it that way.